No, I am not dead. Stop saying that. Greetings, people of YouTube. Duck and Creepers here, and today I am back from the dead. Or at least a few people thought I was dead. I got a surprising amount of comments in the past while that are like, Duck, are you dead? It's like, no. For those who are wondering, I was just in a period of inactivity since real life was making me exceptionally busy. I was rathering to spend my free time working on mods, like the one you see behind me, that I'm going to be showcasing today. And I just didn't really have a lot of time for making videos, and I wanted to make higher quality videos that are actually edited properly. And now I'm hoping I can do that. I recently got Lightworks free, and it seems to work phenomenally as a video editor. And it can handle Fraps files much better than Movie Maker can. So that's good. I needed something that could handle the large file sizes of my videos. And now hopefully I can edit them nicely so you're not sitting there watching me go or just walking around and doing nothing a lot of the time like tends to happen in my current Let's Plays and minigame videos and what have you. No more lobby sitting unless someone says something particularly interesting, so a lot of you will be happy about that. A lot of people were asking me to at least cut out the lobbies. I will be doing that in my videos from now on. But anyway, that's enough ranting about the channel. You're not here for that. You're here about the mod, more materials, version 1.2.1. It's the latest version as of me making this video on July 9th, 2014. Obviously, there are going to be newer versions at some point, and if you're playing a newer version, then I'm sorry, the showcase is going to be a little dated, but if you're playing 1.2.1, hey, this is going to tell you everything you need to know about the mod. If you are playing a later version, I promise you I'll make an updated showcase at some point, where it might already exist and you're just not looking for it hard enough. Look, open your eyes, Padawan. So, more materials! This is my Minecraft 1.7.2 Forge mod. So, you'll notice that the mod adds a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different material classes. All the materials that fall into these classes share textures, basically, and share a lot of other properties as well, like all woods are harvested with axes and all stones with pickaxes and such. Stones have 5 aesthetic variants, tiles, and smooth. And all stones share those variants, and cobble, bricks, carved, and tile stone are cyclable. If you put them in a crafting table, like cobble will give you bricks will give you carved just by itself in a crafting table, and it cycles around. And if you want to get smooth, pop any of these 4 in a furnace. Now you'll also notice every block has a lit variant. What you're going to want to do is take whatever the block is, you're going to want 4 of it, and you're going to want to throw it together with a lighting block from the same theme, which I will get to later, and if you craft them together, you'll get 4 of the lit version of whatever that block is. Yes, everything can glow in this mod, you're welcome. Woods have 3 variants, sanded planks, ornate planks, and panels, all of which are cyclable. Sands are pretty unique in what they do. So you have the base sand, you can smelt it into glass, or you can craft 4 of them into a sandstone. Sandstone currently has 3 variants, rough, smooth, and glyph sandstone, all cyclable. And you can light those. You can't light glass or sand, by the way. Anything that falls or is transparent, like sand can fall, you can't light it up, okay? Okay. Gravel, you'll craft the base gravel. You can put 4 of them together to get gravel bricks, which the only difference between them and the regular gravel is the bricks and tiles don't fall, and you can light them up. Dirts also fall. If you want to make them into something more useful, adobe bricks, which is currently the only variant of adobe, you're going to want to pop it in a furnace to get dried dirt, and then craft 4 of those dried dirt together to get an adobe brick block. Marbles. They have 3 variants, smooth, chiseled, and pillar. Those are all cyclable, and you can light them up as well. And then the base lighting blocks all only have 1 variant. But they can be crafted with everything to get lit versions of that, and I don't know why you wouldn't do that anyway, so I didn't really put a lot of concern into having these with multiple variants, when it would have made the crafting recipes more difficult, and most people are most likely to just craft them into a lit version of a block anyways. Okay, so this is the panorama of everything the mod has to offer. You saw it in the intro. This is as of this version. All of these are craftable in the vanilla game by itself, so you do not need any other mods to get the materials for this. It just requires some pretty fancy crafting, which we're going to go over now. So each material is going to have information about it listed. It's going to have its name, the theme it's from, and the class of material it is, and it's going to have a few statistics. Now, themes, there are 5 of them that are added by the mod, and they determine what type of lighting you need to craft that material with in order to get its lit version. So, like, in the case of the overworld, it's lit coal. Nether theme, it's glowstone. End theme, radiance. Volcanic theme, magma gem. And dungeon theme, hellfire. Slate is a stone from the overworld theme. Now these numbers down here are probably of little interest to your average mod player, but for those of you who are really into the statistics of every material, these explain things. So slate has a hardness of 2. That determines how long it takes to break with a pickaxe, or any tool for that matter. So the higher the hardness, the more difficult something is to break. Obsidian has a really high hardness, for instance, that's why it takes so long. And it has a blast resistance of 10. The lower a blast resistance, the easier a block is to destroy by explosion. The higher that number, the more difficult it is. Everything from the volcanic theme, by the way, has a blast resistance of 2000, putting it on par with vanilla obsidian, and making it just about impossible to destroy it with explosions. And mining level determines what level of tool you are going to need to break a block. And in the case of slate, that is 1. Now, what does that mean? So mining level corresponds to tool tiers. For reference, things that can break with a wood pickaxe or wood tool are tier 0. Things with stone tools are tier 1. Things with iron tools are tier 2. And things with diamond tools are tier 3. And then, of course, version number indicates which version of the mod the item was added in. So you're going to want to be using that version or later if you want to actually have that item in your world. So yeah, slate, hardness 2, blast 10, mining 1, version 1.0. It is crafted with 6 cobblestone in this arrangement. For those who are wondering, the arrangement is the standard galactic letter M. The standard galactic alphabet is the alphabet used in enchanting tables. And since the mod's called More Materials, and I wanted a way to make things easy to obtain without conflicting with any other mod's crafting recipes, I thought using that shape would be a pretty unique and clever way to make things craftable. So just about every recipe in the mod for creating the more materials blocks is going to use that shape. Glacier is another overworld stone. It has a hardness of 1.5, a blast resistance of 7.5, and a mining level of 1. It was added in version 1.0. You can craft it with ice, but that's not the only way to do it. You'll find that with a lot of materials, the things I show you here are only fairly basic. I show you one way of doing it. There's usually lots of ways to craft the various items added by the mod. For instance, you can also craft glacier stone with packed ice. So experiment a little bit, or use NEI to find out more recipes. I'm just giving everyone at least one way to obtain things so you're not completely lost trying to obtain some item and having no idea how to do it. Tonalite is another overworld stone. It has a hardness of 2, blast resistance of 10, and mining level of 1, identical to slate. It was added in version 1.1, and you get it by crafting 5 cobblestone along the right and bottom of the grid, and putting cocoa beans in the top left. Now, these cocoa beans are the first instance you're seeing of what the mod refers to as catalyst items. Basically, what happened was there were lots of items in the vanilla game, but creating things that use exclusively one item, you run out of materials fairly quickly. So I created catalysts as an attempt to expand the potential materials I could create. Now, if a recipe uses a catalyst, which is different from the other 5 blocks required for it, crafting recipe output will only be 5 instead of 6, basically making the catalyst act as like a paint for everything else. Tonalite is one of those items. Claystone is another overworld stone. It has a hardness of 1.8, a blast resistance of 9, a mining level of 1, and it was added in version 1.2. You craft it with hardened clay, and that's all there is to it. Oak is an overworld wood. It has a hardness of 2, a blast resistance of 5, and a mining level of 1, and was added in version 1.0. You craft it using 6 of the vanilla oak planks. Though if you want to, you can use the logs too. And yeah, oak. Birch is another overworld wood, no surprise there. And it's crafted in the same way as oak, just with birch planks or birch logs instead, and it'll get you a bunch of more materials, birch planks. Without all those annoying little dots, you see them? Yeah, I don't have those. Nobody likes those, okay, Mojang? Jeez. Also, fun fact. While everything else seems to use oak wood textures in the vanilla game, item frames actually match birchwood. Just thought that was an interesting little tidbit. Bruce, another overworld wood. Hardness of 2, blast resistance of 5, mining level 1, version 1.0, crafted with spruce planks or spruce logs. Jungle, overworld wood. Hardness of 2, blast resistance of 5, mining level of 1. I think you're seeing the pattern. All the vanilla woods are the same. And you craft it in the same pattern. Jungle planks, yeah. Acacia, another overworld wood. Added in 1.7, by the way. One of the perks of being a 1.7 mod, you get to use the new planks in your recipes. It has a hardness of 2, a blast resistance of 5, a mining level of 1, was added in version 1.0. Dark oak, another overworld wood, hardness of 2, blast resistance of 5, mining level of 1, version 1.0, craft it with dark oak planks. Yeah. Desert, it's an overworld sand. You can craft it out of the vanilla sand. And you make it, and you use it. It has a hardness of 1/2 in sand or glass form, and a hardness of 1 in sandstone form. Sand is unique in that it has 2 separate hardness values. If it's in sand or glass form, it'll have the lower value, and if it's sandstone form, then it will have the larger value. However, both have a blast resistance of 5 and mining level of 1, added in version 1.0. Mesa is another overworld sand. You craft it using the vanilla red sand. Finally a use for that stuff, because let's be honest, it's pretty useless. It's just kinda there. It doesn't have its own unique traits, really. All you can do is make it into glass. Fantastic. But now you can do stuff with it. So yeah, Mesa Sand. You craft it with the vanilla red sand, and you get the Mesa Sand, and you build with the Mesa Sand, and you boop, done. You can have red pyramids now, if you so desire. And it has a hardness slightly better than that of desert sand, 0.55 in the sand and glass forms, and 1.1 as sandstone. Blast resistance of 5, mining level of 1, also added in version 1.0. Breccia! Try saying that 10 times fast. It's an overworld gravel, and by the way, for those who question whether this is a real word, it is. It actually means a random aggregate of various rocks. So I thought it was the best thing to call the vanilla gravel. And you craft it using 6 of said vanilla gravel. And it has a hardness of 1, a blast resistance of 5, a mining level of 1, and was added in version 1.0. Flint is another overworld gravel. Yeah, finally another use for this stuff too, in case you don't want 900,000 arrows. It's an overworld gravel. It has a hardness of 1.1, a blast resistance of 6, mining level of 1, was added in version 1.1. And to craft it, you're just going to need the 6 flint, plop them in the table. You got your flint gravel. Silt is an overworld dirt based on the vanilla dirt, and is crafted with 6 of the vanilla dirt. And dirts are another material type that has that same dichotomy as sands and sandstones, where some things are harder than others. So the dirt blocks have a hardness of the lower number, but when they're crafted into adobe, they have the higher number. So yeah, hardness of 0.5 or 1, blast resistance of 5, mining level of 1, added in version 1.0. Tundra is another overworld dirt with a hardness of 0.5 or 1, a blast resistance of 5, and a mining level of 1. You craft it out of snow blocks, so you can make igloos. Isn't that fun? I think it's fun. I mean, let's be honest, you don't like having igloos that can be instantly destroyed with shovels, do you? Do you enjoy that? Because I don't enjoy that. I hate when people tear down my igloos so easily, so make it more difficult for the griefers, if nothing else. There you go, there's your reason to use this mod. You can have grief-proof igloos, or at least grief-resistant. Clay is another overworld dirt. Has a hardness of 0.625. Yes, that's the only thing in the mod that has a three-digit hardness. I don't know why I did that, but I did. Or in Adobe form, 1.25. It has a blast resistance of 6 and a mining level of 1, and was added in version 1.0. You can craft it with 6 vanilla clay blocks. Isn't that delightful? Diorite! We get to diorite, the first of the marbles. And, for those of you who are familiar with the content of the 1.8 update, you'll be like, wait, Duck, that's from 1.8. Yeah, it is, and now it's in 1.7. You're welcome. Now, with all marbles, you craft it using 2 of a particular stone, and 2 of a particular gravel. Andesite and granite are the exception to that rule. Ironically enough, the 1.8 spin-offs don't obey the same rules as everything else. But it has a hardness of 2 and a blast resistance of 10 and a mining level of 1. Andesite is another overworld marble from 1.8 that I added to 1.7. It has a hardness of 2, blast resistance of 10, and a mining level of 1. However, this one you craft with 2 diorite and 2 slate instead of 2 slate and breccia, which is the pattern most things will follow. Most things will be a stone and a gravel, but this is a marble and a stone. Similarly, granite is an overworld marble with a hardness of 2, blast resistance of 10, mining level of 1, and it is crafted with 2 diorite and 2 breccia put together. Isn't that fun? If you're wondering, yes, I basically replaced the quartz that 1.8 uses with gravels, because I like that better. It's less expensive, and doesn't glorify quartz as much. Now, lit coal is the overworld lighting block that's used to create all the little lit blocks you see along the top. Use it to light everything else by putting 4 of that object around it in the crafting table, and that'll light them all. You craft it with a bunch of coal. So yeah, it's the overworld lighting block by itself. It has a hardness of 1/2, a blast resistance of 5, and a mining level of 1. A quick note is everything that you normally wouldn't be breaking, so things that are like glass and glowstone type things that normally don't have any harvest tool, they use pickaxes now. And everything is acts sort of like silk touch in the sense that what you see is what you get when you break it. No more breaking glass and having it disappear. No, this mod's glass will stay even if you smash it with a pickaxe, which I think is quite useful and makes it quite less obnoxious to build things out of glass. Now we arrive at the nether theme, the second of the 5 themes. Are you getting bored of listening to me speak yet? I'm getting bored of speaking, so my apologies. But it's gameplay stuff. It's kind of important, that way you know how to do everything. Anyhow, scoria is a nether stone. It has a hardness of 1.5, a blast resistance of 10, and a mining level of 2. Which, for those who forget what I said earlier, means it requires an iron pickaxe or better to mine. Which is one step up from the overworld theme. And you craft it with 6 netherrack, and you get scoria. Feudalite, another nether stone. The same values as scoria, hardness 1.5, blast resistance 7.5, mining level of 2. Although this one was added in version 1.1 instead of 1.0. And you craft it with 5 netherrack and a lapis lazuli as a catalyst. Kabismo! This is probably one of my favorite names in the mod, by the way. For those who are wondering of its origin, it's named after an obscure type of tree, more commonly known as, like, dieselwood, I believe. But I heard the name Kabismo was a very seldomly used name for it, and I thought that sounded really good. And it's fitting, because it's a fire tree fuel, I guess. Uses blaze rods in its crafting recipe. It has a hardness of 3, a blast resistance of 7.5, and a mining level of 2. Added in version 1.0, it requires 5 acacia planks with a blaze rod as a catalyst to create it. Now, you can also use 5 acacia logs, but that means you're going to need 4 blaze rods over here instead of the 1. Yet another one of those recipe types that you're going to have to find for yourself based on the pattern. Because if I was to show you all the recipes, I would be here until I was, like, bored out of my skull and the video was, like, 3 hours long, and nobody wants that. Soul is a nether sand. It has a hardness of 0.75 or 1.5, a blast resistance of 7.5, and a mining level of 2. It was added in version 1.0, and you craft it using soul sand from the vanilla game. Yeah, I know this texture is a bit more interesting than that one, but at least you can use it as a sandstone now and build it useful things with it and not have it slow you down constantly. I mean, let's be honest, soul sand was one of those things in the vanilla game that only has value because it's somewhat rare. You can't use it for a lot else other than summoning withers, and you don't really need a lot for that, so it's one of the more useless items in the vanilla game normally. But this makes it useful, so yay, go soul sand. Chalk is a nether gravel. It has a hardness of 1.25, a blast resistance of 6, a mining level of 2, and was added in version 1.0. And I know that nothing in this recipe actually comes from the nether, but I thought it worked pretty well, especially considering real chalk is white and stuff. Okay, it works. Shut up. You craft it with 5 gravel and a bone as a catalyst, and you get a bunch of chalk gravel. Laterite is a nether dirt with a hardness of 0.7 or 1.4, mining level of 2, and was added in version 1.0. You get it with 5 dirt and nether wart as a catalyst. Quartz is a nether marble. It has a hardness of 1.75, a blast resistance of 9, mining level of 2, and it's from version 1.0. And it is unique among the marbles in that it is craftable from a vanilla item. It uses quartz blocks. However, you may also craft it from scoria and chalk, for those who don't have a lot of nether quartz already. And that makes it somewhat useful. It's kind of weird. It's the only item that's also an ore, but I felt like I definitely had to use it, so this is how I did it. I thought it would be silly to not have it craftable from the standard vanilla item, so you can do it both ways. Glowstone is the nether's version of lighting. It has a hardness of 0.5, a blast resistance of 5, a mining level of 2, and was added in version 1.0. You craft it from 6 of the vanilla glowstone, and you get the more materials glowstone, nothing new there. And you use it to light up the nether theme. We arrive at the end theme. The smallest of the 5 themes, but arguably one of the coolest ones, because you get to theme it after that crazy dimension that you get to go to and you beat the game. And hey, spoiler, for those of you who have made it this far in the video, I intend to add another type of stone that uses a dragon egg as a catalyst. So basically it's going to be the most OP building material in the game, so stay tuned for that. I'm also probably going to find some way to craft dragon eggs, probably requiring the first one, so if you're savvy about it, you can create infinite dragon eggs. And I'm not sure how I'm going to balance that if I go that route, but I definitely will be using the dragon egg in something from the end theme in the near future, so stay tuned for that. Now, Suevite is an end stone, and I don't know how many times it's going to rain in the middle of my video, but it is crafted from the vanilla endstone. Ironic enough, Suevite is an endstone, and you craft it from endstone. Silly double use of terms. Anyways, it has a hardness of 3, a blast resistance of 15, and a mining level of 2. It's added in version 1.0, and it's fabulous, because you can finally use endstone to build stuff out of. I like to argue that Suevite is the slightly more practical one, because unless you're up against explosions constantly, this is a lot easier to do than the volcanic theme stuff. Gigellia is an end wood. It has a hardness of 3, a blast resistance of 10, a mining level of 2, and it's from version 1.0. You craft it with jungle planks or jungle logs with ender pearls as a catalyst, and it's purple. How cool is that, right? Another one named after a very obscure tree. Another one of my favorite names from the mod. It's cool. Just be in awe of the amazingness, okay? Okay. Stardust is an end sand. It has a hardness of 1 or 2. It has a blast resistance of 15, a mining level of 2, and was added in version 1.0. Crafted with 5 of the vanilla sand and an ender pearl as a catalyst. Travertine is an end gravel. It has a hardness of 1.8, a blast resistance of 10, a mining level of 2, and is from version 1.0. You craft it with 5 gravel and an ender pearl, and you get travertine. Yay! Tektite! It's an end dirt. And yes, I know it has nothing to do with actual tektite, but I liked the name, so shut up. At least it's related to space. Which Swevite is also, by the way. Swevite is the stone created from meteor impacts. Just little petrology tidbits. I actually went on the Wikipedia page, list of rock types, and went and picked out some good-sounding ones that at least vaguely represented what they were in the mod. Like, Feudalite is actually blue and stuff. It was fun, actually, trying to come up with good names. Anyway, ramblings aside, it's crafted from 5 vanilla dirt, an ender pearl as a catalyst, has a hardness of 1 or 2, a blast resistance of 10, and a mining level of 2. It was added in version 1.0. Nephelinite is an end marble. It has a hardness of 3, a blast resistance of 15, and a mining level of 2. It is crafted with 2 Swevite and 2 Travertine. By the way, you can switch the order of these in the recipes. You can have, like, the Travertine in the top left and the Swevite in the top right, and as long as they're diagonally adjacent, it will work. Yay, symmetry! Radiance! I know it says Radiant Block right now. I'm probably going to change it to Radiance Block in the next update, but we'll get to that. It's an end lighting, and it is crafted from 5 glowstone with an ender pearl as a catalyst. It has a hardness of 0.5 and a blast resistance of 10, mining level of 2, and version 1.0 it was added in. Yay. And now we reach the fourth theme contained by the mod, the volcanic theme. Arguably the most useful of the themes. It has the most powerful building materials. They are extremely difficult to break and completely blast resistant. Now, the first stone from this theme is obsidian, volcanic stone. Crafted from 6 of the vanilla obsidian, and has a hardness of 30, which actually isn't as much as the vanilla obsidian, but I wanted it to be slightly less obnoxious to build with, actually. Has a blast resistance of 2,000, same as vanilla obsidian, and same as everything else in the volcanic theme, with one exception that I'll get to in a second. The mining level of 3, meaning you need a diamond pickaxe to break this stuff with any modicum of speed. Adamantine is a volcanic stone. Its hardness, blast resistance, and mining level are all infinite, meaning basically there's no way to break it at all in survival mode. And as such, I did not make it craftable. I don't understand why so many people make craftable bedrock, but I refuse to be one of them. I mean, there might potentially be in the future some way to create an alternate version of it that has the same... Well, it has the same appearance, but it's not completely unbreakable. This is for people playing in creative mode who want to create unbreakable buildings to ensure there's no foul play among players of maps. For my favorite purpose, making jails on servers if you have the mod installed. You could just make a jail out of this stuff and make it so people can't teleport out and then they're trapped forever, even if they can normally break things. Next is ebony. It's a volcanic wood. It has a hardness of 20, a blast resistance of 2,000, a mining level of 3, and was added in version 1.0. I decided to be somewhat ironic and pick the softest of the real woods here, so you're going to need 5 spruce wood and an obsidian as a catalyst to get ebony planks. Very useful. Now you can have wood that doesn't explode or catch fire. Actually, none of the mod's woods catch fire. They originally did, with the exception of Ebony and Cabismo, when I was writing it in 1.6. My 1.6 development environment corrupted, And now that I'm in 1.7, none of the fire methods actually work properly, so nothing's actually flammable. Now, I'm sure most of you would think of that as a good thing. I do. I'll add in the flammability if there's enough requests for it, and I can figure out how to do it, but for now it'll stay nothing burning. Volcano sand is volcanic sand. It was actually formerly known as volcanic sand, but I changed it to be a bit more consistent with the other sand names, being a noun instead of an adjective. And it has a hardness of 10 or 20, and a blast resistance of 2000, a mining level of 3, and was added in version 1.0. You're going to want 5 soul sand, which is different from the old recipe that used to require regular sand. I changed it to soul sand to make soul sand slightly more useful endgame. And you use obsidian as a catalyst, and you get volcano sand. Pumice! Something I should mention about the volcanic blocks is that in their extreme hardness, they are unique in being the only falling blocks that require diamond tools to break, so they are very useful for creating traps. If you're the type of person who likes to create traps, just a small note, drop a bunch of pumice on your friend's head and he is not getting out of there. Or she, I guess. Not gonna be sexist, okay? Don't sue me, blocks. So yeah, drop a bunch of gravel on your friend's heads and they gonna die. Suffocate in a wall. Cause it's really hard to break. It's certainly hard to break fast enough to get out of if you're panicking while suffocating and whatnot. So pumice is a volcanic gravel. It has a hardness of 12, a blast resistance of 2000, and a mining level of 3. It was added in version 1.0. You craft it with vanilla gravel and obsidian as a catalyst. Ash is a volcanic dirt. It has a hardness of 6 or 12, a blast resistance of 2000, a mining level of 3, and was added in version 1.0. You need 5 vanilla dirt and obsidian as a catalyst to craft it. Basalt is a volcanic marble. It has a hardness of 30, a blast resistance of 2000, and a mining level of 3, which, for those who are wondering, makes it just as good as obsidian for keeping people out of things. It is crafted with 2 obsidian and 2 pumice. Shocker, I know. And yeah, quite useful that. Magma gems are the volcanic lighting, and they are quite expensive, as I wanted to make the most powerful theme have a somewhat expensive way of lighting it. Plus, it looks really badass. I mean, red lighting? Come on, that's awesome. So, you craft it with 5 diamonds and a lava bucket as the catalyst. For those of you who are players of lots of mods, you will probably appreciate this. Because anyone who's ever picked up Tinker's Construct quickly finds little use for their diamonds a lot of the time. And now there's something you can use them on. It has a hardness of 10, a blast resistance of 2000, and a mining level of 3. Serpentite is a dungeon stone. The first item of the last of the 5 themes, and the most recently added. Everything from the dungeon theme was added in version 1.2. So it is a dungeon stone. It has a hardness of 2, blast resistance of 10, mining level of 2, and was added in version 1.2. Craft it with 6 of the vanilla mossy cobblestone, and it's completely green instead of just somewhat green, which I think looks cooler. But anyways, yeah. Next we have migmatite. It is another dungeon stone. It has a hardness of 1.8, a blast resistance of 12, and a mining level of 2. It was added in version 1.2 as well. It is crafted from 6 nether bricks. So you can pimp your nether fortresses with cooler alternate textures and glowiness and whatnot. Ironwood, a dungeon wood, has a hardness of 3.5, a blast resistance of 15, a mining level of 2, and was added in version 1.2. Craft it with 5 oak planks and an iron ingot as a catalyst. In keeping with the theme of the dungeon theme having some various ores as catalyst items, we have sylvanite, which is a dungeon sand. Has a hardness of 1.5 or 3, blast resistance of 15, mining level of 2, added in version 1.2. Craft it with vanilla sand and a gold ingot as a catalyst. So now you can build your treasuries out of this stuff. Instead of just straight gold blocks. Makes it slightly more efficient. and just as pretty, I reckon. Diavundi is another dungeon san with a really strange name that I kind of came up with on the spot with weird languages. I don't even remember which language Vundi is from. It means dust, and then I just tacked diamond onto it and called it a day. Sounds pretty cool. Couldn't think of anything better. So dungeon sand has a hardness of 1.5 or 3, blast resistance of 15, mining level of 2. Add in version 1.2. You craft it with 5 vanilla sand and a diamond as a catalyst. Turbidite is a dungeon gravel. It has a hardness of 1.1, blast resistance of 6, mining level of 2, and was added in version 1.2. You craft it with 5 gravel and a mossy cobblestone as a catalyst, and you get turbidite. Decay is a dungeon dirt. It has a hardness of 0.75 or 1.5, a blast resistance of 6, a mining level of 2, and was added in version 1.2. Craft with 5 vanilla dirt and a piece of rotten flesh. Yeah, you can build things out of decaying zombie meat now. You're welcome. Olivine is a dungeon marble. It has a hardness of 2, a blast resistance of 10, a mining level of 2, and was added in version 1.2. You can craft it with 2 serpentite and 2 turbidite, and you get olivine. It's pretty fun. I like the color. It's kind of obnoxious in large quantities, but if you use it as like an accent for things, it looks pretty nice. Porphyry is the other dungeon marble. It has a hardness of 2, a blast resistance of 10, and a mining level of 2. It is crafted using 2 migmatite and 2 turbidite, and it's orange and pretty and fabulous. Last but not least, we have Hellfire, the dungeon themed lighting block. It's a hardness of 0.75, a blast resistance of 6, a mining level of 2, and it was added in version 1.2. It's crafted using 5 blaze rods with an ink sack as a catalyst. So there you have it, folks. More materials. You can add lots of things that you can build with and play around with, and it's fun. In the future, it's going to support mods, so leave a like if you want to support that idea. I mean, come on, how cool will it be to have options for building materials within other mods and stuff? I think it's going to be awesome. Now it's just a question of waiting for a lot of my favorite mods to update to 1.7 so I can add support for them. Of course, I have a few more things I need to do before I start doing that, but it's going to be awesome. Just wait until you see where this is headed. Thank you all for your support of this project. I can't even fathom some of the view counts that I see for it. It's awesome to know that there are downloads that are as high as they are, views that are as high as they are. It makes me really happy. I like creating content. I hope you guys like my content. And if you do, like this video, so I know that. And look forward to more awesome stuff yet to come. I'm Ducking Creepers, this is my mod, I'm back to YouTube, and better than ever. See you guys next time. Bye!